C4 and Bryan Nehman.
Baltimore's live and local radio show.
WBAL News Radio 1090, FM 101.5, and the WBAL radio app.
We're pleased to be joined in the studio by the county executive from Harford County, Bob Cassilly. Good morning, county executive.
Good morning. Good morning, C4 and Bryan. Good to be here.
It's budget time, and we've talked to different county executives about how they are dealing with their budgets, and particularly the education part of their budget, considering, you know, that what Kerwin has in place, the blueprint. How is your budget doing, particularly as it comes to your obligation, public education?
Yeah, so we've been, after last year's budget travails, I sat down with our superintendent and of education and in the schools and really came up with a process to try to alleviate the stress coming into this year. And so we opened the books and work together. We were trying to align the funding with the demands. And we were doing pretty well until the downturn in state revenue really threw us off of our track. And as a result of that, they came in at $40 million more than us, which is a pretty, you know, sticker shock there coming in. And so that's caused a good bit of angst. On the plus side for them, they've got that in savings. If they want to do that, they can do that. I'm not in favor of a full $40 million increase, but they've got that within their power. But we did come to a pretty good alignment over this whole past year of opening the books and looking. And I know there was a legislation to compel opening the books for the boards around the state. Honestly, from our perspective, we'd already done that by agreement.
Okay.
We'd already worked it. My budget team was looking at their books and vice versa. And so I understand why folks would want that. In Harford County, we got together with Dr. Balson and my staff and did that. But it still came up with, this whole process just really revealed the challenges that we have in making the theory of Kerwin, which I saw as a state legislator when Kerwin...
And you filibustered.
Which I did filibuster successfully. I'll ask, but,
there you go.
The theory on how Kerwin's supposed to work versus reality now as county executive, where we're talking real numbers and real budgets and not theoretical. And I did listen to my friend President Ferguson discussing the budget and discussing Kerwin on your show. I've been there. It looks different in theory in the General Assembly, but it's a lot different out here. And
I want to get to that, but I do want to pinpoint something. You said that they have $40 million in savings the school system does in Harford County. Where does that come from? Like, how does that work?
Sure. Well, I call it savings. In the technical term, it's fund balance. That the Board of Education receives payments for the budget over prior years, and what you don't spend, you put in your fund balance, and it builds up. And
so they've got $40 million in a savings account, essentially.
Well, it's not a savings. It's in accounts. It's on their books. It's in their accounts. But you'll see that throughout the state. Boards of Education will have this throughout the state. They call it the fund balance.
Okay.
And for us, they'll have committed fund balance and uncommitted fund balance. But that's taxpayers' money that was given that wasn't fully used. And the idea is, well, you build that up, and then maybe you'll say, well, we'll use that to build a new school or something.
Exactly.
All right. So, but they have been arguing that if they don't get the full funding from you, they're going to have to cut programs. Like summer school is going to have to go away. Some sports stuff going to go away. You're not going to have trainers
at
athletic events. So are you suggesting that they use that $40 million for all of those things? And do you think that it is accurate and fair that they're saying, hey, if they don't get a $40 million extra from you, that all of these things are going to be cut?
So absolutely, it's not true that if they don't get that $40 million from the county government, they have to cut all those things. They're sitting, and Dr. Bolson admitted that the other night in the Board of Education meeting. Yes, they're sitting on $40 million. They could apply to that. The board needs to make some decisions on tightening up, just as my county government did. You know, I spent the last year really revamping and reviewing every bit of our operation, eliminating leases. Just, you know, these are tough times. You gotta be much more frugal. And I'm encouraging the board to do that. We've got to look. You got a lot of senior positions that have nothing to do with the classroom. It's time to back off and say, wait a second. Do we need to do things? This ought to be about putting money into the classrooms, not into the bureaucracy. And I would encourage the board to take a look and pull back. Throwing $40 million more just accepts the status quo. I would encourage them, which they could do, I strongly encourage them to say, let's look at this and let's let's not do 40. Let's pull right. back. And but you don't have to kill programs.
But you gave them more money than they got last year, right?
We took maintenance of effort plus another $1 million on top of that.
Okay.
Our plan was to go a little bit above that, but when state revenue went down, we lost $13 million off the top. And so
I want you to make that point, County Executive. Yeah. Harford County Executive Bob Cassilly is here in studio. We've heard this from other county executives as well. You just don't have education in your budget. You have public safety. You have sanitation. You have other things in your budget that have to be met as well. And just talk about that for a second, because it's like Annapolis sometimes views you as only an education county executive. You have other things to do.
Yeah. No, you're right. And from the minute people walk out their door, or even before that, you're getting your water, your sewer, your roads, your parks and recreation, the housing, everything, the services for the aged, the addicted, all that stuff. So it's a massive budget. I think we're about $731 million or something just in operating this year. And so it is a zero sum. What I take from them to give to the board, I reduce services, and we're pretty efficient in Harford County. We're working to make it more. We're not giving up. We're going to continue to do that. Your only choice after that is increase taxes. And I think even the Democrats in Annapolis are saying, no, it's not the time to increase taxes. That's the wrong way to approach this.
But do you see that there's any possibility of them being able to continue this without raising taxes in Annapolis?
I think if Annapolis looks at what they're really doing, Annapolis, if they're going to stay with the current plan, I don't know how they get around this without a massive tax increase. But what we had asked before, and the big eight county executives were all pretty unanimous on, is you got to relook at this and reprioritize what Kerwin means. Let's focus this. And that was the big challenge with Kerwin in theory coming in. Yeah, you had some schools that were really deficient. But instead of just focusing on what's going wrong with those schools,
you make it statewide.
Let's rewrite education policy for the entire state. Well, a lot of our schools were doing really, really well, putting out professionals and engineers and doctors and doing a pretty good job. But we said, no, we're gonna wade into everything and redo all of education. And that's the big challenge.
That's a massive cost.
Oh, it is. It is. And now there's these incongruities within the current law. You say the state says, well, all you got to do is provide for more pre-K, but they don't. What about the buildings for that? Right. We got no money for that.
Yeah,
well, I don't either. Right. Let's raise the starting teacher salary. Okay, what about all the teachers who are currently making that starting teacher salary, the new one at $60,000, and they've been there for 5 or 10 years? Well, we're not going to give you the money to increase all those. Well, how do you do that? How do you have starting teachers making the same salary as people being there? And how do you have a uniform salary statewide? Newsflash: it costs it's a whole lot. It's more expensive to be a teacher downtown Rockville than on the Eastern Shore or far western Maryland.
Right,
so the statewide thing. How do you reduce teachers' classroom time? Sounds great in theory, but when that teacher comes out, I can stop mowing fields to save money. Just don't mow the field, and the grass grows up, no big deal. You can't take a teacher out of the classroom and not put somebody back in there. The kids are still there. So, teacher out of the classroom. Who's paying for that substitute? So it's these incongruities that are forcing us as county executives, and they'll say, hey, you can still do all your local initiatives, but I don't got the money now. And Kerwin has made it clear, and the authors have made it clear, they don't care about class size. They don't care about they're not thinking about security of your schools. They're not worried about extracurricular activities, athletics, art, music. That's just not even in the formula.
But most Marylanders don't accept that. That's what Kerwin and Blueprint was going to be, as opposed to what we're getting.
And there is no parent who would have said, "I'm all in favor of Kerwin." If you're gonna increase class size, reduce safety and security, reduce extracurricular activities, dial back on athletics and arts and entertainment, music. No parent would have been in favor of that. But that's what we bought into because we just didn't talk about it. And that's not the way to go here. And those are the fiscal realities that we face every day now, that Annapolis can pretend, in Annapolis fashion, but that's not even there. Don't talk about that. So
your budget is balanced.
Our budget is balanced, and we're moving forward. I think we put appropriate focus on public safety. You got to do that. We're going to continue to work with our school board. in the coming years. And we're just praying that Annapolis has an epiphany and says, wait a second, this isn't all we, you know, this isn't quite what, as it was advertised. Let's start dialing back here and align theory with reality. Listen to the county executives a little bit. A lot of us have been in the General Assembly before.
Yes.
We understand the theory piece. I was there. A number of us have. But we need to focus on really get back to the basics here, right? And I'm from Harford County, the Ripken way. Focus on the basics and get it done. And that's what we got to do.
Well, County Executive Bob Cassilly, time always runs short on us, but we really appreciate you coming in. And maybe next time we talk, we can talk about how your county is dealing with the juvenile justice legislation in terms of dealing with the juvenile crisis really across the state of Maryland.
Great
always
to see
great
you,
to have you.
Great to have you.
Appreciate
it.
Take care.